In this second Coding and Linework video, we will look at some of its more advanced functionality, specifically focusing on auto code selection, where Leica Captivate automatically suggests the next code for us to measure, allowing us to quickly and easily measure repeatable features. To do this, we will continue to use the same scene from the first Coding and Linework video. As we can see, we measured most of the scene, but the road was left completely unsurveyed, so in this video, we will measure that road. First, we will clear the list of code boxes and build a new one on the fly as we measure the road. We clear the boxes by going to the second level of function keys and selecting one of the clear options. Here, we will clear all boxes, not just one. Now that the code box list is empty, we can build a new list, selecting each code as we come to it as we go across the road. We will start at the very left edge of the road with the code footpath. We know that this will be the first footpath we measure on the site, so we can leave this as line number 1 and measure our first point. Instead of continuing our footpath string, we can straight away move across to the second feature in this cross section. Here, that is a curb, so we select that code. Again, it is line number 1 because it is our first curb, and then we measure the starting point. As with the footpath, we're not going to measure a second point on this curb line. Instead, we'll continue across the road to the center line. Here, we select the code, again leaving it as line number 1, and then measure its starting point as well. As before, we'll only measure one point on this line before we continue across to the other side of the road. The next line we need to measure is again a curb, our second curb for this site. As we already have one curb and are now adding another, Leica Captivate recognises this and has automatically set the line number to 2. So again, we just need to press measure to record our first point of this line, and then we can move across to the final part of our cross section, our second footpath line. Once again, we just measure the first point of it. Now that we have walked all the way across the road, measuring the start of every line, we have actually built up a list of code boxes that perfectly matches the cross section of our road. This allows us to use Leica Captivate's auto code selection feature. This is where Leica Captivate automatically suggests and selects the next code for us. We activate this by going to the second level of function keys and entering into the toolbox. Here, there are 4 options to do with auto code selection. The first two are the storing and loading of code templates. So if a list of code boxes we have created is one that we want to save and use repeatedly, then we can do that here. Or, if we have previously saved lists of code boxes, we can load them in now. The next two options allow us to start auto code selection, either by zigzagging or always in the same direction. Zigzagging is where it is assumed that we want to use each of our selected codes first in one direction, and then turn around and use them in the opposite order, then back again in the original order, and so on, reversing the order we use the codes for each pass through. The same direction option assumes that we always want to use the codes in the exact same direction as they exist in the template. So as soon as the last code is used, Leica Captivate would loop back around and select the first one again for us. If we had already turned on this functionality, then we would also have the option to turn it off in this screen. But for now, as it is not yet on, as we don't need to store or load a template, and because our example best suits the zigzag mode, we'll simply select zigzag. Now our job is just to measure the point that Leica Captivate is prompting us for. As the footpath is a highlighted code, that means we need to measure the second point on our footpath. Once we have done that, Leica Captivate automatically moves to the code curb, so we need to measure the second point on our curb. Now we are prompted to measure the center line, so next we'll do exactly that and measure the second point on that line. Because Leica Captivate is helping us, all we are having to do is move to the next point on the suggested line and press measure. This is making our job easier, as the code selection is automatically done, so that we are focused on measuring the right point and what is around us, not only increasing our efficiency, but also increasing our safety, which is especially important on active construction sites and when working close to busy roads. Now that we are reaching the end of our road cross section, we can see the zigzag function in practice. After we measure the last code, Leica Captivate actually keeps the focus on that code, so that we can then use it to measure the starting point of the next cross section. All of this auto code selection really is great, but sometimes there are additional features, for example, this manhole, that are not in our list of code boxes. To measure this, we need to pause and then later resume the autocode selection. So we go to the second level of our function keys, and this time we press pause, which stops the autocode selection. This means that it stops Leica Captivate from moving the focus to the next code box, and also it allows us to start editing those code boxes. We could now use the define button to change one of our code boxes to manhole, but instead we will simply add a new code box for this and use it to measure the manhole. Here we can notice that after measuring that point, there was no automatic focus or code box movement. This is because we paused autocode selection. As there is only one manhole here, and we do not need to leave this code box in our list, we can straight away remove it by selecting to clear one code box. Now that our list of code boxes is back as we require for measuring the cross sections of the road, we can press resume and continue doing exactly that, with the autocode selection enabled again. We could quite happily continue working like this using only these functions, but instead, let's take a look at using line geometry within autocode selection. As we saw in the first coding and line work video, it is possible and easy to interact with the code box to modify the geometry of lines. Actually, doing this with autocode selection enabled is no different to when we did it for a single code. We simply select the type of geometry that we would like to use. Here, we are using an arc, and then we measure the first point of the arc. But instead of continuing along the arc, we move on to the next code. We can change this one's geometry as well. Actually, we can change the geometry of any code box whenever we want, and start and stop features as we please. As we continue along this road, using the autocode selection and taking care of geometry, we are very quickly and easily collecting great data that really does represent the site in front of us. Now, there are some situations where we're not able to measure every single code in our list. When this happens, we need to use a skip command. An example of this could be when we're measuring across the road, where we're able to see the path, but there is a parked car stopping us from measuring the curb where we would like. As we are still being prompted to use that code, we could pause and modify the list of codes to remove curb, but that is not what we want to do, because it is likely that it is just this one time that there is something in the way. Instead, we will use the skip command. When we press skip, we're just telling Leica Captivate that we won't make that one specific measurement, but we do want to continue with our autocode selection. The final feature to now look at in this second coding and line work video is very different to autocode selection, because it is when we manually pick which line we want to measure to. Here, instead of using the focus and the code boxes to define what line to measure, we will actually tap on the line itself. We press and hold on that line and then use the menu that appears. On this menu, we have quite a few functions regarding this line. We can use continue line work to allow us to measure more points to it. We can reverse the line so that any new points we measure to it would be used to build up the line in the other direction. In other words, they'd be added to the line before its current start point. We can edit or delete the line. We can use the line in another app, such as in Roads, or we can have Leica Captivate deselect the line for us. We want to continue the line work, so we select this, and Leica Captivate then makes sure that the code box is in the list and that it is the highlighted code box. This means that when we measure, we know that it will be given the correct code and added to the line as we desire. That now brings us to the end of surveying new points for this video. We could, of course, continue the survey and finish off the road far into the distance. However, we're all comfortable doing that now, and instead we will stop and take a look at what we've accomplished so far. The easiest way to do this is to tap the button that hides the split screen, allowing our data to be shown full screen. Then we can go into our viewer's configuration, turn off the point codes so that we have a purely visual representation of our site. And here we can see that thanks to all of the features covered in the two code and line work videos, our dataset now fully represents the site that we needed to survey, bringing our site work and this video to a final close.